Okay. Okay. Okay, cool. Okay, okay. Yeah.
The views, the views on, oh, on all the channels?
Yeah. How do we get those stats?
Firstly, the network's real. I'll give you a general view of what they can see. The network's getting data real time. Uh-huh. Facebook's really strong. 24,000 hours, 60,000 hours. Wow. Very good number, day one. And the Chinese broadcast was a ratings in this morning.
Wow, that's awesome, man. Awesome. That's good. We don't need the fans.
Just keep promoting CSE.
Right. Yeah. Have they been telling us to keep dropping it in?
Oh, I had a meeting with their marketing people yesterday. It was hilarious.
Yeah. Yeah, we've been dealing with them for months, so.
I've got one saying, well, if you hadn't screwed up all the accommodation, maybe you'd be helping you out.
Yeah.
I can't say that.
Maybe just a slight mention. Oh man.
Yeah, good. Like Kenny, those guys are so funny. I love it.
It really is.
Jeff Shee and James will be doing this tomorrow. They love it. They'll love it. You're not doing it tomorrow, right?
I am.
What?
Yeah.
You're doing the whole time?
Yeah.
2 minutes, okay. Oh.
Hi all and welcome back. Thanks for joining us here at the beautiful Studio City Macau for the Super 8 Asia Premier Invitational Tournament with top teams from China, Japan, Korea, and Chinese Taipei. I'm Alex Olin, joined by my colleague and friend here, Alex Yamashita. And we've got some great matchups tonight. Alex, what's on the agenda this week?
Well,
I got to say, we got a slew of great basketball ahead of us. We have a two-group format of play here. Group A with the Orions, Pauyan Archland, Ryukyu Golden Kings, Shenzhen Leopard. Group B, Chiba Jets, Fubon Brave, Seoul Samsung Thunder, and the Zhejiang Guangzhou Lions. What we're going to have here is the first 3 days, we'll have a round-robin tournament. Each team plays each other three times. And then advancing on to the semifinals, where the top two teams from each group advance, followed by the finals in day five.
So we had some great group matchups last night. Ryukyu Golden Kings, Shenzhen Leopards, both coming away with wins in Group A. Goyang, Archland, not quite fortunate, losing. Seoul Samsung Thunders, they look really strong. Chiba Jets look very strong as well. We've got Fubon and Zhejiang going away with losses. And tonight, we've got some very great matchups. Alex, what do we got first off?
Well, kicking us off right here, right now, we got the Fubon Braves versus the Chiba Jets. That starts in just a few minutes, followed by the Ryukyu Golden Kings versus Pauyan Archland. Game three will have probably the biggest matchup of the night, Seoul Samsung Thunder versus Zhejiang Lions, and to cap it all off, the Shenzhen Leopard versus the Orion Orions as our final game for the evening.
All right, and I'm really excited to get this kicked off. Fubon versus Chiba. Those Chiba Jets played fantastic last night. They all looked on the same page. Yuki Togashi is a fearless leader. Atsushi Ono's got these guys all playing on the same page. This is a very, very strong team. Fubon's got their hands full tonight.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yesterday's win by the Chiba Jets was huge. I think they really, really showed that they have the potential here to win this tournament. And Fubon, meanwhile, they played a very interesting game last night. They played a very high-energy, up-tempo game. They sort of lost steam towards the very end, but they're looking to redeem themselves tonight.
They're a well-coached team. You know Roger Shue's got them playing hard. You know they've got the scheme. Let's see if they can keep up with the Chiba Jets tonight, and let's see if the Chiba Jets can stay on the roll that they were last night.
Oh, absolutely, and we may just see another broken backboard. I don't know if the audience or the people tuning in right now are aware, but yesterday, Tom Gaffney came in and made a huge splash in the third quarter as he went up high, tried to slam it down over the defender. As you can see from the footage, the backboard was shattered. It was a Shaq-like moment, and I believe the highlight even made a lot of global international news.
Oh yeah, this was all over the news. Tony Gaffney, this not happening since Shaq days. And I think Tony Gaffney has since promised he'll do his best not to do it again.
All right, then. Well, here we are. We have the two teams taking the court, captains shaking each other's hands, getting ready now for the jump ball. Tip-off is right underway, ladies and gentlemen.
And here we go. It's time to get started.
All right, we'll have Edwards now and
Garrett Seiler going off of the jump ball.
A bit of a 1 minute delay here. They're just readjusting the basket height.
Bear with us for a second, folks. Once again, we're in this beautiful Studio City Event Center, Studio City Macau. Beautiful venue to host the Super 8 Asia's Premier Invitational Tournament.
Yeah, this is actually my first time here in Macau, and I gotta say, I was pleasantly and pleasantly surprised by the scale of the venue here.
And once again, folks, this is inside a hotel.
This is inside a hotel. This is inside a casino. It's pretty spectacular. I think that going forward, Studio City and Macau will likely be the go-to destination for plenty of sporting events here in the region.
Yeah, just a fantastic resort, fantastic location. Spoken with all the teams and all the players today. They're very happy to be here. They love just walking 5 minutes down to the arena, down to the locker rooms. Some great restaurants available inside. Really, there's no reason to leave the resort.
It's pretty amazing, too. It's only an hour away from Hong Kong by high-speed ferry. All right, well, Alex, what do you think are some of the interesting key storylines here? I for one, am going to be very curious about the point guard matchup between Togashi and Joseph Lin.
You know, I really like this point guard mashup, especially for Fubon. They're a little outmatched talent-wise, but I think Joseph Lin, he's a quick guard. He can keep up with Yuki Togashi on offense. I'm not sure that Bohannon and Seiler are going to be able to stay with Edwards and Gaffney. Edwards had a monster game. Gaffney, of course, had that monster game. Aki Chambers had a monster game. Ono can shoot from outside. This Chiba Jets team just has so many weapons. And then you've got the engineer who makes it all run with Yuki Togashi. I mean, this guy made zero mistakes last night.
Yeah, he definitely orchestrated the offense to a T. He reminds me a lot of Chris Paul as well, too. Smaller, scrappier, but always extremely well composed, very well prepared, and does not make unforced errors.
Yeah, this kid is scary. Scary good. He's 24 years old. Just a lot of potential.
Well, here are the results from the game yesterday. I think kicking us off, we had the Orion Orions, who fell by one in overtime to the Golden Kings in the debut opening game of the tournament. And the second game was a high-speed, up-tempo affair. The Seoul Samsung Thunder defeating the Fubon Braves here, who are playing right now, by 14 points, 93-79. The third game, Zhejiang Guangsha Lions versus the Chiba Jets. That was probably the marquee match for the night. We had two heavyweights, one from Japan, one from China, really duking it out. It came down to the very end when the Chiba Jets pulled away by 7 points. And as the nightcap, Paulian Archuland, who put up an amazing fight, they really, really hung in there versus a very stacked Shenzhen Leopard team. Ultimately, however, the Leopard were able to use their size and their talent to pull away at the end as well, too, 86-74. So we are now approaching game one of the second day of the tournament, and I think we're going to have just as good, if not better series of games.
Oh, yeah. I think the games just get better and better each day. Take a look at some of the highlights from yesterday from the Chiba Jets. You see Ono, who can just put it up from three. Just one step, shoot, in.
Yeah, this is the start of a big game for Edwards. I mean, anytime that jumper's falling in from the outside, you know that things are just going to open up for him inside. People just need to respect his J as well, too.
They could just do so much. They're such a well-coached team. They're so meticulous and methodical. I mean, these guys just know how to ball.
Yeah, their preparation is truly top-notch. Alex, I think you were mentioning to us yesterday the extent to which team management goes to make sure that no detail, no stone is left unturned. They cover all the bases from what degree temperature?
Yes, inside their rooms. What players are eating, how players are sleeping. I mean, this Zhejiang Guangsha team is nothing to underestimate. These guys lost to a very good Chiba Jets team. They're going to likely come back with a vengeance. I know they're very frustrated with the loss. It was Giannis Bruce's first time ever playing with the team.
All right, well, here we are. The game is just about to start. Tip off here now.
Hold on, we're going to reset that one.
All right. The Braves control the tip.
And let's see how they want to tempo this. They're usually a fast-paced offense, but the Chiba Jets are a fast-paced offense as well, and you do not want to get going in a race with them.
Sal is definitely trying to establish position early here. On Edwards picks up a quick foul.
Edwards called for the early foul. He's not happy with that.
Let's take a look at that one more time. Both bigs trying to establish position there. Oh, nice hesitation move, but a rejection from Edwards.
And that's what we see with the Chiba Jets. Edwards, Gaffney, Chambers, these guys are big and they just bully you on both sides of the court.
All right, inbounds here. 7 seconds left in the shot clock. Joseph Lynn.
Finds an open Joseph Lynn. He's going to pull the trigger.
Sala with an offensive board. Second chance.
Can't quite get it to go.
All right, let's see how Togashi here is going to orchestrate the offense.
Did such a great job of that last night. Let's see if they change their game plan up at all for this Phubon Braves team. It's a much different matchup. There's Michael Parker to start it off for the Chiba Jets. Bohannon can't get it to drop. This is what I'm talking about with Yuki Togashi. Just the speed. Finds the open guy. Ono for a good look, but can't let it go. Ah. Bohannon can't get the tip back.
A little bit of a careless foul there from Bohannon.
Yeah, I think he just wanted that.
Well, in the early going, it definitely seems as if the Jets are trying to force the issue, keep the tempo up high.
And look at that.
Ono slices through the middle. Beautiful,
guys. Beautiful surgeon. Getting into a little bit of foul trouble early.
Here we go. Ooh, look at that beautiful finger roll. Togashi just slices through the middle.
I mean, just takes advantage of a defense that usually gets set pretty quick, but this guy's just too quick. Can't get it, Chiba can't get it to drop.
Well, Phubon is very lucky that they're only down by four right now. They haven't been able to establish any sort of rhythm. Chiba really is just taking it to them.
Garrett Seiler rolls out on him. Phubon still yet to get a point, get a basket. And that's got to be a foul.
Well, they're definitely running a lot of high screen and roll here and running some play action off of the picks. Trying to get that ball moving. Oh, look at that again. Wow.
Lost it in there. And that's a good position.
Phubon finally on the board.
And it looks like Phubon's going to try early to keep the ball out of Yuki Togashi's hands. Smart move. They're going to call a foul on Garrett Seiler.
Oh, he definitely clipped him a little bit.
Oh, he did. That's a good call. Gosh, he gets it at the top of the key. Get a drop and Ono with the rebound. Wow.
Ono is called for a bit of a foul here. Let's see exactly what this is all about.
I didn't see it, but nice.
Sorry,
drive
not a
here.
Foul, but a warning. Ono still seems a little bit confused. Oh, a little bit of a miscommunication right there.
And that's one of the first misfires we've seen from this team.
Well, Togashi was looking for Edwards, but Edwards did not see his teammate giving him the lob on the back screen.
Didn't quite get that to go.
Off the fingertips of Siler. Jets ball. We have Togashi's family.
Oh,
Lin with a rejection.
Lin with a nice block on Togashi. And he matches up well.
That's definitely one thing that I think Lin has the advantage over Togashi with, which is he is bigger, he is longer than him.
And Ishii's going to put him back on top.
That's definitely something that they should try and establish.
That tie game did not last long.
Lin gets it back. Both teams still a couple of careless turnovers. Pretty low scoring affair here as we are just about midway through the first quarter. Fubon with only 4 points, Chiba with 7.
Fumio Nishihara is going to come in. The guy's just going to take a seat.
Open look.
Let's see if Aki Chambers can get it going for the Chiba Jets. Subbing in.
Chan right here, handling the ball. Back to Lin. Siler inside with the and one.
And it looks like they're actually calling an offensive foul.
Let's take a look at that again. Oh, it was the elbow and the extension that came through. Caught Edwards in the face. Salah with quick two fouls now, taking a seat. And this is where I see Chiba really trying to make a move. With Salah out and only Bohanan as the lone big, I believe that Chiba will look and try and establish position down low, and they do that immediately.
And they go to just that.
Edwards here has the clear advantage over Bohanan. Bohanan may be a little bit more athletic and longer, but Edwards has a much better, much more sound inside-outside game. We'll look to see him take advantage of that matchup.
I agree. Edwards arguably was the best player last night.
He had, what, 30 points?
30 points, yes. I think he was one of the highest scoring players last night.
One for two from the line, 8-4.
Gashi and Gaffney both eager to get back in.
Edwards with the second rejection of the night. Open look. We have Nishimura from the corner with a three.
Lin can't get it to go. Michael Chambers can put it on the floor and take it up. Parker, I'm sorry.
I think that's where we have the evidence of just how dangerous and potent Chiba can be. The difference between them and a lot of other teams, as we can see right here, is the ability for the Chiba bigs to be able to put it on the floor, lead a break, and do more than just be down low.
Oh, yeah, this team is so dynamic.
But this meanwhile, you see here, Bohannon having a little bit of trouble bringing the ball up the floor. And that's really where the difference is. Substitution as Edwards takes a seat. Chambers comes back in.
Joseph Lynn gonna sit down as well. Nice move inside.
Bohannon with
the put back.
Effort points, they're gonna need those tonight. I think in order for the Braves to really make this close, they're gonna have to really cut down on unforced errors and win the 50-50 chances. All the loose balls, all the effort points, offensive rebounds. They're gonna have to grind if they wanna truly test this Cuba Jets team.
Oh yeah. They've gotta go at them hard if they wanna stay in this, and they've been doing just that. The score does not quite reflect that though. And that's too easy. Oh, but can't get the layup to go. Ishimura, missed opportunity. Bohannon from deep. Rolls off.
Both teams struggling to find a basket right now. Fubon still in single digits with only 2 minutes left to play in the first quarter.
There's Nishimura.
Chiba is just so dangerous from 3-point line.
They can just do so much. And they do it all well. Take a look at this. Nice pass to find him in the corner. Nishimura in the corner. Just nails it. Fubon throws it away.
Nishimura filling in brilliantly for Kotegashi.
Nishimura is, he'd probably be a starting point guard anywhere else, or starting guard at least.
Oh, absolutely. He has a lethal corner three. He has very good pace, and he's able to put the ball on the floor and get through creases. Definitely a starting five level talent.
Man, this Chiba team plays great defense. Come away with a steal.
Find the open man. Great ball again. Movement there. Again, from the same place. I believe that's three threes right now from Chiba from the right corner.
Shudahara making his presence known. Fubon's got to call a timeout.
Fubon's going to think it over.
A little over 1 minute left in this first quarter, 16-6. Chiba over Fubon.
X 做得很好啊，可是你必须要看着光，然后去传那个球啊。你不看光，这样传全部被抄掉。防守的时候，如果你刚这边做到 blue，他把球传掉了，那你要赶快回来啊。这边远边永远会有一个后挡的。
Seems as if the Fubon coach is a little bit concerned right now about the defensive rotations for his team. He's explaining about how creases will happen, but you need to trust the rotation to be there.
Oh yeah. And right. That you cannot leave your man alone. You cannot right now, Chiba. These space. You cannot space these Chiba chess players.
Right, right.
Make you pay for
it. Yeah, Chiba is just having the ball movement really start to open up holes with each defensive switch. As they go down and down upon the possession, they're figuring out ways to get the open man free, and Fubon just needs to communicate better and be more diligent with that. They need to continue to rotate, continue to switch, and just trust that their communication will get them there.
Yeah, they're still in this game. We learned last night, these Chinese Taipei teams, they do not go away.
Turnovers will not help, though.
And
here we go.
Gosh, he's going to rush
a 3-on-2
beautiful pass from Aki Chambers to Tony Gaffney.
And this Chiba team is deep as well, too. Right now, they basically have Togashi, the starting point guard, along with four players from their secondary unit.
I mean, frankly, this Chiba bench could be a whole other starting team.
Behind with a beautiful turnaround in traffic. Stems the bleeding a little bit. But the deficit is still 10 seconds left to go now in the first quarter.
And here's Yuki. Finds an open guy, can't finish.
2 seconds left, I would expect to see, I would actually expect to see some sort of a three-pointer at the end.
We'll see what Fubon wants to do. They do not have a lot of time after he makes these, or misses these free throws.
I'm sorry, it's a foul.
First one's an air ball.
That's a little bit embarrassing.
A little bit.
Oh, they're having a laugh about it right now.
And you know they'll be cutting that one up when they watch Phil. Can't get the second one to go either. 2 seconds, that's going to do it. They had a chance, but after the first quarter, Fubon, it's Chiba over Fubon 18-8. Stay with us. We'll be back in just over 2 minutes. Aki Chambers saying that he wants to go up by 20.
Well, I think that's definitely something they should do. Just go for the jugular.
Garrett Tyler got the tip from Fubon. But Chiba started things off. And they've dominated on both sides.
Well, right now, Fubon really does need to step up. Somebody needs to take control of this game. Somebody needs to show that they're not going to go down lightly. The momentum does need to shift.
We'll see how Roger Shu rallies his team.
All right, we have the second quarter underway right now. Chiba Jets fully in control of the game. Togashi taking it up. It's an 18-8 score right now as we have Chiba look to increase and add
with
to their
nice
lead.
Speed. And this Chiba team picking off right where they left off yesterday. They just held a high-scoring Fubon team to 8 points in the first quarter. Hockey Chambers misses.
Thus far, stifling defense from the Jets. Let's see if they can continue the defensive intensity here in the second quarter. And they
Gaffney's
do.
Gaffney's going to take it away. Let's just pray he doesn't break the backboard.
With a breakaway. For all the Kicks lovers there, he's actually rocking the Generation 2 Air Jordan 11 Space Jams.
And those do look good on him.
Not the first one.
That was travel.
Fubon on the scoreboard, 20-10. First bucket of the second quarter for them.
Gaffney from deep. And he has that kind of range.
So there we
He's
see.
Smiling after that one.
The depth and the versatility of Chiba. They have their second string big, Gaffney, who just showed the full arsenal here with a breakaway steal and dunk coast to coast, followed up in the immediate possession after with an open three that he just calmly knocked down without hesitation.
Oh yeah. And Luke Gaffney told me, or Tony Gaffney, excuse me, told me earlier, he's played in Israel, he's played in some of the top leagues in the world. And he thinks this Chiba Jets team matches up with just about anybody.
I can see why.
Bohannon with a nice move and can't finish.
Oh, the putback there. Close but no cigar.
And you've got to connect on those.
Oh no, double teamed.
Gaffney turns it over. But Fubon turns it right back over. And Chiba turns it over again. Three turnovers in a row.
No look pass.
Make it four.
Couldn't handle it. Pass was probably a little bit too far down low. Bounced off Chiwei Lin's foot. But luckily for Fubon, they still regain possession. Bohannon trying to get his troops to calm down a little bit. The frenetic pace is not doing them any favors right now.
Bohannon not matching up well against Gaffney.
And here we get
Gaffney's just a little too much.
Taking it coast to coast. Leading the break.
Fubon. From Wuxian. It was a nice play. Trying to keep Fubon in this thing. Fubon playing much tighter defense.
Charging foul there. I believe it's number 44, Shinsuke Ito, called for the charge.
That's a good call.
Let's take a look at that again. Oh, definitely a bit of a push and a jab.
Definitely an offensive foul.
Well, Chiba still is in control of this game, very much so. 25-12. Just under 7 minutes here in the second quarter. Tough defense here. Fubon does get it back though.
But Calgiani can't connect.
Ito now gets fouled himself. Siler, I think, again with the foul. He just checked in, ladies and gentlemen. And with less than 30 seconds after checking in, he's picked up, I believe, his third foul.
Siler is struggling against a much faster Chiba Jets team.
Let's take a look at that again. Oh, that's definitely a bit of
a foul. That's definitely a foul.
Sala has a very old school game, doesn't he?
He does.
Post play. A game that's probably much more suited to the slower style of play that we used to see in previous decades, but basketball is changing.
Wow. Edwards taking Sala down low.
Edwards is definitely going to look try and use his quickness here.
Move on with an air ball. With the guy, she's gonna collect it. Edwards, nice pull-up jumper.
Well, Chiba is really starting to run away with it here. 29-12,
feeling it.
They've definitely found their groove, both defensively and offensively. And it's the defensive pressure here, I think, that has really, really been the key to their offense. Steals, losing the turnovers, leading to easy fast break points. Right now, Fubon is definitely in trouble. Chiba is rolling.
29-12, with a little over 5.5 minutes in the second quarter.
Fubon's going to have to go back to the drawing board and figure out what they are going to do against this Chiba juggernaut.
Oh, yeah. They need a whole new drawing board.
Right
here, the football coach is talking about how they need to provide better weak side help. The ball movement, the spacing of Chiba is really leading to a lot of weak side basket opportunities. But the Braves, frankly speaking, just have to close off. There's nothing to it. They have to increase their defensive efficiency, and they have to put an end to the momentum here that Chiba has really, really taken hold of.
Yeah, this Chiba team finds your weaknesses, and they exploit them.
Lynn, again, met with stifling defensive pressure. Siler there.
Shot clock violation for Fubon.
Sala there is looking extremely tired.
Oh yeah. The whole Fubon team is having a little bit of trouble keeping up with this Chiba team. Edwards wide open. He's going to hit that 10 out of 10 times.
Nice little turnaround jumper there from number 12, Timothy Burke. Alex, I think yesterday I was saying how Edwards has a power forward version of Brook Lopez's game, but upon watching it even further and examining him, I think actually Al Horford is perhaps more
That's
similar.
A very good comparison. They both have a similar style of play. They both play extremely hard. They both have a good outside shot.
Very skilled, consistent 17, 18 foot jumper, able to take it to the hole, put the ball on the floor. Edwards, I think, perhaps has slightly better ball handling skills than Al Horford, which is saying something, given Al Horford is a 2-3-time NBA All-Star.
Just love seeing this Chiba team that's added a lot of pieces this offseason. Edwards, Gaffney, Chambers, these are all new guys who have granted have played in Japan before, but this is their first year with Chiba Jets, and it looks like these guys have been playing together since junior high.
The defense here continuing to strangle the Braves.
what they do here. Tagashi.
Tagashi having his way with the defense.
And his change of pace. He can go quick. He can stop on a dime. Must be incredibly tough to defend. Bohannon with a great offensive rebound and one.
The effort points here. Bohannon trying desperately to keep his team within striking distance. But 16-33, the deficit remains large. Let's see if Fubon can really try and close the gap here and bring it down to single digits as we enter the half.
They've got to get something going if they want to stay in this.
All right.
He's going to connect on his free throw.
17-33 here. 3.5 minutes remaining in the first half here. We have the Fubon Braves versus the Chiba Jets. Ono with a nice spin.
Very nice spin. Can't get it to go. Joseph Lynn's going to push at the tempo.
And look how fast Chiba gets back on defense. Lynn had what seemed like a fast break opportunity, but before he could get to the paint, he already had four or five, a swarm of red shirts surrounding him.
Oh yeah, this team does not give you anything. Lynn can't get the first one to go.
Ono here trying to back his man down. Finds the open man, Parker. That could have very easily been another basket for Chiba.
Turns it over again. Ishimura's going to push it. Parker, Gaffney, extra pass to Ono.
Open man here. And one.
He gets to roll.
Chiba is rolling right now, ladies and gentlemen. The score is 35-18. Another and one by Michael Parker as he looks to make a three-point play the old-fashioned way and put his team ahead by 18.
And they're so fast. They had about four or five open shots there. Either one of them were good shots.
Parker converts that easily. Fubon here just be totally outclassed. Chang here with a nice move. Lefty lay-in and one. They really need more of that. Last night we saw a lot of individual brilliance from Chang. I was actually very impressed with his ability to slash, take the ball to the hoop.
They need to see more of that tonight.
He's a classic swingman. Guard-like ball handling skills, small forward size, great athletic ability.
He connected on some good threes last night too to keep them in it. And that's been the difference with this game. Fubon shot very well from three-point range last night. 62% in the first half. I don't know if they've hit a three yet.
I think somebody just really needs to step up. So far we've had Bohannon try with his efforts via three-point plays, putbacks, offensive rebounds to keep his team in it. But the Braves really need somebody else from the perimeter to help out.
Well, they can't get it to go, but Gaffney's there for the rebound.
Fubon needs somebody to step up and make a statement and say they're not going to go down slightly, because right now Chiba is just toying with the Braves.
It is not pretty right now.
two for two. 38-21, the lead is back up to 17. Again, the defense of the Chiba Jets really preventing any sort of good open look for the Braves.
And rep goes down. He did not see that.
A little bit of a miscommunication there right now with the Jets.
The rep is a price. Looks like he's all right, though. Quick recovery. Back on his feet.
Gaffney there.
Gonna replay this. Oh, just got blindsided.
Oh, they gotta make those.
Miss again. Another offensive goal for Fubon.
Number 14 of the Fubon Braves, Wen-Cheng Tsai. I've noticed he's actually missed a lot of layups over the past couple games. I think I counted 5 missed layups previously, and he just ripped another one.
This Fubon Braves team, they've been plagued by a lot of turnovers today. And you can't do that against this kind of Chiba Jets team.
What a strip.
There's another strip. Back in Chambers. Great to see the Michael Parker. And they'll take that all day.
Alright, 41 seconds left here. Quick timeout by Fubon. They're down by 19. Chiba in full control of this game. Let's see if they can continue to press forward and continue to out-execute and out-class their overmatched opponent, frankly speaking. Chiba Jets are going to continue their game plan. High pick and roll action. Shooters on the side. Flashing out on the wings. Creates a lot of play action and a lot of ball movement, which ultimately sets up lanes and or open shots for their spot up shooters. Meanwhile, the Braves are just trying to hold the fort here.
Fubon's stressing they need better ball movement.
They just need to prevent this from turning into a complete landslide. One for two. Nishimura here, back in the game. Way outside, Gaffney.
Gaffney can't get it to go. Let's see if we want to capitalize. Nice drive to the basket. Those are some easy points.
Chai needs to do that more. He needs to continue to be aggressive. He has the ability to cause problems for Chiba at his height. 6'5", able to put it on the floor.
That'll
be the end of the first half.
It is halftime, and we have the Chiba Jets up comfortably 40-24 versus the Fubon Braves. It's really been a story about defense leading to offense here, Alex.
Oh, yeah. I agree. The Chiba Jets offense, of course, they're very potent. They score in a number of ways. Led by Yuki Togashi, Nishimura comes in when he needs to, and he can lead this offense very well as well. But this Chiba Jets defense, just unyielding. They don't let Fubon have anything.
It's the turnovers, I think, that are really, really hurting Fubon right now.
那我们进攻上面必须要减少自己的失误，在对方的压迫防守之下，那再加上我们必须要减少自己的犯规，因为一旦有犯规或者失误的时候，球权就是交给对方，所以能够减少这两样的发生，才有办法再把分数追上。你对对手Chiba Jets他们的打法，他们的有对他们有什么评价？就是他们比较无私，就是愿意去传导球，所以五个人去分享球，所以我们防守上面会比较困难。
And the Fubon head coach is really speaking about the selflessness of the Chiba Jets. So willing to pass. 40-24, Chiba leads.
And now, let's welcome the Super
All right, well, ladies and gentlemen, here we are at halftime at the gorgeous Studio City Macau. The halftime score right now between the Chiba Jets and Fubon Braves is 40-24. Fubon is having a very difficult time with Chiba's size, length, and talent.
Not to mention the speed of the Chiba Jets. They're so fast. They pace it so well. I mean, these guys make you play at their own pace.
Absolutely. It's the versatility here, Alex, that I think is what really separates Chiba from Fubon. They're bigs that run about four or five deep. They can all put it on the floor. They can all shoot. They have low post moves, too, in addition to being two-way players. So I think that's really what the advantage comes down to. Meanwhile, Fubon is having a difficult time precisely because of the fact that their bigs, Garrett Seiler, while large and dominant down low, just can't keep up. He's not able to put the ball on the floor. He can only play one way, and that is low post, classic big man style, which in today's more open run and gun style, that really doesn't suit.
And Bohannon is a face-up guy. He does not like to back you down, and he usually wants to go around you or pull up for a jumper. And Edwards, Gaffney, Michael Parker, they all welcome them. And they've been playing him well. They've been playing this Fubon team very strong, not giving them anything. There's been no open passes. Fubon needs to find something that works.
All right, well, we have the Fubon Braves down 16 points to the Chiba Jets. The score is 24-40 in favor of Chiba. Let's see if Fubon closes the gap in the second half. We have a couple highlights here. Start the game, Togashi slices through the lane. Beautiful one-handed floater. Meanwhile, they keep the pressure. Nishimura, that was one of many threes from that right-hand corner. Nishimura is probably one of their best spot-up shooters from the guard position. Here we go again, exactly the same place. Nishimura, nothing but that splash.
And this Chiba Jets team, they're so unselfish. Again. You never see these guys take more than two dribbles.
Again, Chiba from that right-hand corner. Here we go again. It's been all Chiba this half. Beautiful. No look over the shoulder pass.
Aki Chambers and Tony Gaffney. Those guys will connect again when Gaffney can go deep for three.
Gaffney showing that range. And here we go. Gaffney showing the versatility coast to coast. He's going to take it, fakes the pass, layup. He wanted a call there. Edwards, their star from last night. Elbow jumper, money.
And they just have too many guys that they can go to.
That was one of the few bright spots for the Blue Bars and Braves in the first half. Burke fell with a pretty little turnaround. Ball movement, inside, outside, back inside. Parker with the and-one. Stripped by Aki Chambers. Chambers leading the break. Back to Parker. Easy lay-in. Oh, this is a bit of a funny, funny moment.
Ref taking one for the team. Gaffney showing him some love.
Here we have our halftime match stats. Field goals, the eye test rings true. Chiba Jets pretty hot from the field, 50% field goal percentage. Fubon Braves only at 28.6%. And Fubon, wow, Alex, 0-for-8 from three-pointers.
And that's the biggest change. Yesterday, last night, to start off the first half, they were so hot from three. They were at 62%. That's what kept them in this game. If they had even hit one, two, three three-pointers, they'd be in this game.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I think here, if you look at the assist number, two assists to Fubon versus seven for Chiba. Chiba's ball movement and spacing is clearly paying dividends. That's an extra five easy shots that they've been able to get off of their fluid offense, as well as the crisp passing off the back of turnovers caused by their stifling defense, Alex.
Oh, yeah. And what's not shown here is that the Fubon Braves actually turned the ball over 12 times in the first half. 12 times in the first half.
You can't just have that happen. That's 12 more possessions, 12 more chances to give the other team to score. Even if they make six out of those 12, that's 12 points purely off of unforced errors.
The Fubon Braves also causing some turnovers themselves. Chiba Jets with 10 turnovers in the first half. And we've got the first half stats. Sean Bohannon doing his best to keep him in this game, 9.7 rebounds. But Tony Gaffney, Michael Parker, Yuki Togashi, Fumio Nishimura, just too much. It's too many people to guard.
Oh, yeah. The Jets are definitely the deeper, more talented team here, and they're showing it. Yesterday, they were in for quite a dogfight against Zhe Jiang. Frankly speaking, I thought that Zhe Jiang was the more talented team, even compared with Chiba. But here, they clearly have the advantage, and they're coasting to what seems like what will be an easy win. Let's see if we can be proven wrong.
Well, Chiba showing they are no joke, and that they don't take any team lightly.
I think concentration and focus is going to be one area that the Chiba coach definitely will want to focus on as they try and close this one out. Edwards here is having pretty much a perfect game. 3-for-3, perfect from the field. 7 points, 2 boards, and 2 good big blocks. That I think have really intimidated a lot of these slashers for Fubon from entering the paint and getting those easy buckets that they so desperately need.
Oh yeah, this guy just plays well everywhere. From the field, rebounding, blocking.
Here we go.
And look at that block.
That was the first block of the night for Edwards early on in the game. And here we go, a second one.
And he just tells Fubon to get out of his house.
And if it's not blocks, it's deflections. Here we see him on the offensive end, taking it to the hole.
That's
against
taking
a slower
Siler to the hole.
I mean, in all fairness, I think I should take Siler to the hole. Siler's having a lot of trouble here. Guarding and matching up against quicker players.
He has been struggling this tournament.
I'll tell you what, I give him credit. There's no way I could ever become a professional basketball player, let alone make it to the NBA. But Siler reminds me of a slower, shall we say, more horizontally inclined Al Jefferson.
a little bit. I mean, he's got the power. He's definitely got the strength. He's got the post game. This team has not exactly figured out how to get him involved. They like to play fast-paced, and that's not Seiler's style.
Right, which I think is actually counterintuitive to using and truly weaponizing Seiler. In order to do that, they really need to slow the tempo down, make this a drawn-out affair. I'm surprised that Fubon actually hasn't taken to that tactic to try and cut into this deficit here.
Oh, yeah. Fubon been mainly focusing with John Bohannon. John Bohannon's been keeping them in.
Hey, Tony, good to see you here again. When you were trying to dunk in the first quarter, I was really scared. Were you trying to break the rim again?
No, I was taking it easy on the rim. That 42-minute delay yesterday killed me.
Tell me what you're going to do in the second half.
We got to just keep playing our basketball, focus defensively, minimize the offensive rebounds, and good shot selection, and we'll be okay.
Good luck and have fun.
All right, here we go. We've got the two teams warming up back onto the court. 3.5 minutes remaining in the half before we get the third quarter underway.
And let's see what kind of adjustments Fubon makes.
I think Fubon's really just going to have to muck up the game if they want to get into this thing.
Oh, yeah. Coach Roger Hsu, always scheming, always analyzing. This guy will have some kind of new style. Hopefully he's found some angle to attack this Chiba Jets team.
Well, let's hope so. He really needs to pull something out of the bag here. Otherwise, it's donezo time for his team, and they may just fall 0-2, which would almost certainly be a death knell.
Oh yeah, that's a death sentence in this tournament.
You can win two, you can lose one, but going 0-2 almost all but guarantees elimination.
Especially in their group. Their group is no joke. Chiba Jets, Zhejiang Guangsha, Seoul Samsung Thunders, Fubon Braves.
Wow, that definitely is the group of death there.
They cannot afford to fall 0-2.
Well, when all else fails, slow the game down, muck it up, make it more physical. But then again, you need to have the personnel to be able to do that. And outside Seiler, I don't really see how they can bring the fight to the Jets at this point.
And that is just what they need to do. They need to slow the game down. But the Jets just make you play their game.
Right, the Jets now obviously undefeated, 1-0 along with the Seoul Samsung Thunder in their Group B. You have the Fubon Braves and the Zhejiang Lions 0-1. I would expect the Lions to bounce back tonight, but they are again pitted up against a formidable team in the Thunder. Meanwhile, in Group A, we have the Kings from Ryukyu Okinawa 1-0. The Shenzhen Leopard actually very lucky to escape with the win there after a rather lackluster performance. The Orion Orions 0-1 and Apollyon Archland 0-1 as well too, rounding out Group A.
Yeah, and stay tuned right after this. You've got the Ryukyu Golden Kings versus Puyo and Archland.
That should be a pretty interesting match. I would expect the Golden Kings to come out and really put the pressure on Archland, much in the same way that Chiba has been doing to this Chinese Taipei team as well.
Oh yeah, Ryukyu Golden Kings. They pulled off the win, not happy with their win at all. They thought they could have played much better. They played that same Orion's team a couple of months ago in a preseason friendly match and beat them by nearly 30 points.
And here we see some of the highlights from the first half in slow motion. Chiba has to be happy with their performance. All right, both teams about to take the court. As we kick off this second half, Studio City Macau, day two of the Super 8 tournament, game one, Chiba Jets 40, Fubon Braves 24. That's just another easy one-handed floater here by Edwards. Edwards
just picking off, just picking up where he left off.
Wen Chengcai draws the foul on number 27, Kosuke Ishii. Tsai with a rare make from close range. Edwards easily just blows right past Seiler again. Edwards with a nice steal.
Throws it up to Edwards.
Alley-oop, and just like that, it is again a 20-point lead here.
Fubon needs to stop trying to play fast with these guys.
Offensive foul. That very easily could have been another basket leading to a 22-point lead. But here we go. Let's see the previous possession. Edwards with a nice steal, maneuvers his way through. Give and go. Alley-oop back over to Edwards from Ono. Pretty fast break play.
Nice handles by Edwards. He has the awareness to collect the ball in the air.
They're trying to play high-low now. High-low post, big to big.
Seiler gets to go.
Let's see if he can stay in the game. He's huffing and puffing already. Not even 2 minutes into the second half.
He's heard you talking about him. He wants to prove you wrong. Takashi taking his man wherever he wants him to go. Puts it out to Ono with these two, I believe. Three.
That was a perfect example that we have here of how Chiba really slices apart the football defense. What they do is, with their big's ability to put the ball on the floor, that forces the defense to rotate. And as the rotations happen and they continue to put pressure, at some point there is a defensive lapse. And what that ends up doing is it creates either an opening or an open shot for one of the Chiba Jet players.
Oh, yeah.
And that's basically been their formula tonight. Again, low in the shot clock, pressured. Not the ideal shot that they want. Ono is going to try and take this man down low.
Oh, beautiful pass. Beautiful cut by Michael
Parker. Seiler's just too slow. They're going to have to take him out soon. Just watch. He's not rotating fast enough to cover his defensive assignment. He's bullying his way in there. Trying to establish possession. Position rather. Three on one possibly.
And Yuki's going to make you pay.
Oh, that's just too easy. They're smiling right now. Let's take a look at this one. All right, here we go. Nice behind the back bounce pass.
Gavin Edwards taking away from his teammate Michael Gallagher.
That one is Joe Lamar.
These guys have fun playing with each other.
Wow. We now have a 25-point lead. Chiba has really blown the game open here.
And this is starting to get out of hand.
Fubon's going to have to do something. If this is the playground, I'd say foul somebody and foul them hard. But let's see what the Fubon coach decides to come up with.
アンビッグマンの目切った時にはボールトレーニングを
やる。
Coach Ono, you're saying to continue to try and roll, have the big man roll off of the pick and roll action that they're setting up here. Because he sees, just as we can see here, Alex, that the Braves just have no way to cover them. Their bigs aren't rotating, and that starts with Siler.
They're just too fast.
There's going to be a pin down right here, but Siler doesn't really set the pick properly. Number 14, Wen Cheng Tsai with the bucket. Oh no.
Nice shot from him.
All cylinders firing. Another turnover from Fubon, followed by a foul. That has to be out of frustration. Fubon is just getting... Wow, he's just getting... They're getting pummeled.
Oh yeah, they're getting pummeled. There's no way around it. They're getting pummeled.
Splits the defense. Beautiful move.
Nice job by Parker fighting for that rebound.
These are the kind of plays that Fubon just can't give up, man. I mean, come on, you're down by 25 points.
Oh.
People made the threes off the level play. You can't let some guy come in and take the offensive board from you just so he can put you up again.
And the Chiba Jets bench loves it.
That's about the easiest bucket Siler's had all night. Let's take a look at that again. Previous possession, Ono completely open in the corner.
Just left alone.
Money. Ono, jab step. Let's see if he turns around.
Nice play by Parker.
Wow. The Jets are just outworking, out hustling, outclassing the Fubon Braves here. The lead is now 27, likely 28 after this free throw. Good passing inside. Edwards misses it, but Parker is there to tap it back in. Parker at the line here, midway through the third quarter. 27 point lead. The Braves just have to be demoralized right now.
Fubon's got to figure something out.
Well, for Siler's sake, I hope he didn't eat McDonald's this morning for breakfast.
Say this whole Fubon team needs to change their diet up. Something's not working.
Ooh.
It's an interesting free throw shot. Gets it to go.
Then you guys have seen Charles Barkley swinging golf club. And that was the basketball
look at
equivalent.
That. Just the quickness.
Edwards catching elbows left and right. Lin here trying to make something happen. Nice open look. Fubon here with a bit of a sign of life.
And a bit of a lift.
But just like that, Edwards puts it on the floor, drives, takes it to the hole. The lead is still 24. We have a substitution coming on. 44, Shinsuke Ito. He'll probably come on right after Edwards makes this free throw.
rare miss from Edwards.
Chang, nowhere to go.
Can't break shots like that.
Chang makes up for it.
Fuwan finally gets a three to drop.
Again, second chance points.
Too many of them.
Oh no, they're putting it to the floor. Draws the foul. He'll go to the line for an easy two. Needs to give his brother Jeremy a call. Ask for some help here.
Oh yeah, he needs a lot of help. Playing with this Chiba Jets, playing against this Chiba Jets team. But this is still a young Fuban team. They're still meshing together. They haven't quite figured it out. There's an offensive foul called against.
Number 11, Chi Wen Lin. The Jets have certainly blown this game open. A 23-point lead right here. Oh no. To allow.
Oh, and a rare miss from Ono. Airball. Right?
He had a lot of pressure on that shot. Chang giving him no space to get that off. Less than 3 minutes to go here in the third quarter.
Nice move by Joseph Wynn.
Messed up defensive assignments again. Lin is fully aware. He was screaming for his teammates to help. But Chiba just took the ball out of bounds over the outstretched arms of the defense. Help is too late.
Look at that body control in the air.
Togashi with the and one. Ishimura back in. Great defense from Gaffney. But I believe they called a foul. Right after the strip, Gaffney got poked in the eye. Chang frustrated. Chang trying to make stuff happen.
Fuban needs him to step up, stay in this game.
One of the few bright spots here. Double-digit points. Trying to be aggressive.
He's got a bright future for this big line.
There.
Nice passing, but definitely
Lin makes up for afford to miss those kinds of opportunities.
And just throws it away.
Miscommunication clearly.
Do a little bit too much with that. He should be taking it up strong.
Oh, Ito with another miss down below.
Gaffney is confused, clearly. He actually didn't make a play for the ball, didn't make a play for anything. He's called for the foul. Ball.
He second wants to personal. See that one again.
Take a look at that. I have no idea where the foul came from there.
Do not see it either.
Although I have to admit, the officiating today has been a lot more steady and consistent than at some points yesterday, last night.
Oh yeah, this is a good crew right here.
All right, here we go. Nishimura to Gaffney.
Nishimura going to try that three.
Okay. Oh, Nishimura, a little bit of a cold streak. Three straight threes missed. He, of course, opened the game with three makes. A very efficient three-point shooter. Great spot up shooter, excellent form, no motion wasted.
Not definitely. Look at that. Look at
they
that.
Look at that ball movement. Wow. That big to big passing. That's what makes Chiba really special.
Yeah, this team has got to figure it out.
Oh, and yeah, that wasn't a symbol for what's been going on in this game.
Wow.
Well, here we go. 66-43, Chiba versus Fubon.
All right, and we're back. Heading into the fourth quarter, Chiba Jets over Fubon Grey, 66-43. It was a fairly competitive game, maybe in the first. But Chiba's really run away with this thing.
Oh, absolutely. They've only increased their lead from the mid-teens to now a 23-point lead that they have getting into the fourth quarter. Chiba's really just having their way right here. They made another push in the first part of the third quarter. And since then, they've really just been continuing to coast along. Fubon has offered little resistance. They have a couple of bright spots. Chang has been trying his best valiantly to keep his team in it, but to no avail. I think that we're going to have pretty much most of the same. I'd be surprised if we saw anything different, to be honest with you. Fubon looks quite deflated. They look already defeated. There's still 10 minutes to go.
Oh, yeah. And down by 23 points going into the fourth quarter. That's a big, big pass to ask any team.
你如果pick and roll来不及的时候，你守的那个人是射手，他会投外线，你们必须小的直接守到大的去，大的直接帮小的去。
All right, here we go. Looks like Chiba is going to start the second half with their second unit. Fubon looking to just have their dignity intact.
Let's see if Fubon can get anything going this fourth quarter.
Okay, an aggressive move here by Fubon. Nice to see that. Chen Yi Kao at the line. Aggressive move. But you can't miss free throws. Not when you're trying to cut into a lead.
Definitely not.
Well, too, here out with the second unit plus Siler. They're trying to see if throwing everything but the kitchen sink is going to do the trick.
Oh, yeah.
Gaffney at the line here. Feathery touch. Yeah, the bigs for Chiba are just too skilled.
They just overwhelm nearly any team.
Defensive intensity is still extremely high for Chiba. I think the second unit wants to show that they're not going to let any sort of lead dissipate and that they too deserve to be on the court just as much as the first unit.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that ball movement.
Better, guys. Extra pass. Wow. Wow.
Called a bit of an offensive foul there, but
and they know where everyone's going to be before they're there.
With a 24-point lead as we go into the fourth quarter, 8.5 minutes left. I'm not sure if they're too worried. Nifty ball handling. Nice move. Chen Yi Kao again. He definitely wants to get some more playing time. Good defensive strip as well, too. Hustle
25 points up, and they're still going after every loose ball, still winning the 50-50 plays. Coach Ono has his team exactly where he wants them, respecting the game, not letting up, no mental lapses.
Oh, yeah. He's got the Super 8 championship in mind.
And that very well could have been another three-pointer to push the lead up to 28, but alas, we're here, 25-point lead, missed shot, pushing the ball, Gaffney. Foul on number 19, Wen Chen Liu. You see there, that was another perfect example of how the Chiba bigs run the floor.
Oh yeah.
The guards and the wings are always aware that they'll have a trailer behind them on fast breaks. That's not exactly something I could say for Siler.
It's nice knowing that your big men can run with your guards. And that if need be, your big men can bring the ball up.
Seems like they're trying to run some pick and roll here, but I do think, in all honesty, Fubon needs to go through some pick and roll drills. I mean,
oh yeah,
that pick there was neither clean nor crisp. Ends up actually in a hard foul. That guard changing how needs to endure.
Oh, this Fubon team clearly not quite prepared for the speed and size of Jimmy James.
I just think they just have their hands full. I mean, the only time we have JV beating varsity is when varsity is not prepared. Chiba's definitely prepared, and the talent difference here is just too high, I think, for Fubon to overcome.
I agree. This Chiba Jets team is just too stacked. Chiba continuing to stress to pass. And Fubon stressing defense. It's a little late for that though.
Upcoming game here, we have the Ryukyu Gold Kings against Paoyuan Archland. Again, I hope that this will be a bit more competitive than what we have right now. Paoyuan Archland showed a lot of fighting spirit in their previous match, while Ryukyu was able to pull out a one-point victory yesterday in the opener. Chiba now up 25, 71-46 versus Fubon, so I make that 71-47. As Cao hits free throw number 2. Chiba taking their time. They're gonna probably look to this remaining 7 minutes as a way to practice their offense and continue to try and execute. We got the second unit on the floor now. Closing out the game while their starters take a rest. And impressively, their second unit has really showed their salt. They haven't given up any lead. They've actually added to it. And they continue to push on forward.
That's smart foul there. Oh, I'm sorry, they're already in the penalty.
Wow. 6 minutes remaining. More than half of the quarter to play. And the Braves already are in the penalty. Thank you.
Abe Tomokazu bringing up the court right now. This guy's like a Japanese Joe Brenner. Again, 3-on-1 break. Oh. Gaffney with a breakaway one-handed jam. Lead is now 28 points, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, and Chibo just blew this thing completely open.
And nowhere to go. You see now, just now, Seiler off of the pick and roll, rolls to the basket, but he's 1-2 steps behind. He's probably the most unstoppable post player here on the floor tonight, but with the style of play of today's game, pick and roll action, finishing above the rim, Seiler's having a lot of difficulty. And I think Fubon will really need to think long and hard as they enter tomorrow's match on how they are going to game plan and use the personnel at their disposal to give them the best chance to win the game. Because right now, to me, they're playing two different styles. They've got one guy who plays low post, plays slowly, but everybody else on that team is quick and needs to play up tempo.
Exactly. They haven't quite found a combination that works for them.
Six-point lead to the Jets. Approaching the midway mark of the final quarter. There we go, Gaffney again. Too easy.
Timeout,
Fubon.
Still late to regroup, down by 28 points.
Coach Shu is not happy. I think he's going to have to try and just salvage wherever he can out of the game here. His starters are already all sitting safe for Seiler. He's probably looking at Josh now, trying to think about how best to prepare for the next game. He's trying desperately to motivate his troops on following through with the play. It's easy to get lackadaisical when you're down by 28 points with less than 5 minutes to play in the game.
Oh yeah, they gotta do something to get themselves at least a couple more points. They're getting completely denied by Chiba Jetson.
At this point, it's not even about trying to steal the game. At this point, I think it's really just about your own dignity. I mean, when you get punched, you're gonna take it in the mouth, you're gonna come back and punch back.
Oh yeah, this is about confidence. This is about getting ready for the next game.
You want to build some sort of momentum as you go into the final game. Even if you lose, at least end it on a good note to carry something forward from today to tomorrow.
And a good call there from a ref.
All right, well, here we have. Here we have number 44, Shinsuke Ito. Getting a lot of playing time, second unit.
There's a nice play.
Finally a basket.
Yeah.
look at that. That's Princeton offense right there, ladies and gentlemen. You get the high post big up at the elbow. A lot of down screen, setting it up for guards to come down the middle.
Nice cut from Fubon there, too.
All right, here we go. Let's take a look at this again. Elbow.
Has
Princeton offense right down the middle.
Wow.
Wing players cutting in. That's beautiful offensive basketball. Wow, I gotta say here, Alex. I mean, the refs are actually getting back down onto the court or down the floor faster than Fubon is. That's not a good sign.
Yes. I mean, we talked that Fubon needed to slow their game down, but not on defense.
Now, wow, I think we have one of the refs here rocking Kobe 6s, all black, black Mamba Kobe 6s.
Really?
I give this guy props. And we have another ref rocking, I believe it's full-length Air Maxes.
This man knows his shoes, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, shoe culture is basketball. Basketball 101 there. Is that a three-pointer?
And appropriately, we hear the bell. And that is the bell.
84-53. It's a 31-point game now. Lackadaisical pass. Picked off. Chiba is continuing to just steamroll through. They must have gained a lot of confidence yesterday from their execution.
Oh, yeah.
And win over Judge Young. Well, arguably the most talented team in the tournament. I'm looking forward to game three, Judd Young versus Samsung.
Oh yeah,
that's going to be a phenomenal match.
But before that, we've got the Ryukyu Golden Kings taking on Puyo and Archland coming up next.
It'll be our back-to-back Japanese team versus Chinese Taipei team match here in day two. Joseph Lin with the brick. Again, fast break opportunities. That's really been the story.
Wow.
Fast breaks for Chiba. Siler's only now just barely getting up the court. Missing bunnies.
Can't do that.
Well, it's a 31-point game. 74 seconds remaining, 1 minute 14 seconds left here in this blowout. This phenomenal display of execution by Chiba. They've clinically just picked this Fubon team apart.
Absolutely. And this Fubon team has a lot to correct before their next game, just tomorrow.
I think they're just being outclassed.
Not softening up on defense at all. Giving up by 30 plus points while their Fubon gets an easy layup.
We call this stat padding time. Thank you. That's a rather funny looking free throw.
It does have an interesting stroke detail.
That's how my sister used to shoot it when she was 7 years old. Nice spin, but just can't convert. It's been the story of the match.
Oh, indeed. Look at this Chiba team still going hard.
Here we go, 20 seconds left.
Misses it.
Unrelenting. Coach Ono has his troops focused. The game is essentially, for all practical purposes, over. 32-point lead, 10 seconds left, and still the Jets, they're showing that they're all business here. They're going to dribble this one out. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. That'll be it.
And that does it for the first game, 2-2 at the Super League. Stay tuned, coming up, we got a good one. Here for Golden Kings versus Cleveland Archland.
87-55, the final score. Chiba Jets clinical in their annihilation of the Fubon Braves. We had in the fourth quarter the Jets with their second unit out there adding to the lead. They are making a statement here, trying to prove to everybody that they are the front runners and the favorites to win this tournament. Now 2-0 as Fubon falls to 0-2 after 2 days of competition. Next match, we have the Ryukyu Golden Kings versus Paoyuan Archland. Ryukyu 1-0 and Paoyuan 0-1. After 1 day, they're going to open up game two here shortly at Studio City Macau. The Jets thanking and saluting the crowd here. What an awesome performance we've had.
Hey coach, can you rate your team performance for this game? Rate your team performance of this game. Talk about your team.
It's a very good team.
Now you have 2 wins and tomorrow you guys are playing against the Samsung. What is your preparations for the game tomorrow?
It doesn't matter who we're gonna play against, so we just gonna do what we're supposed to do.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
All right, here we go. We have the two teams now warming up for the next match.
My friend Tony Gaffney with me here at the same spot again. 20 points, 11 rebounds. Is that your expected stat line?
I don't usually care about stats too much. In my 9-year career, I haven't gotten paid to play for stats, but yeah, it's nice to have a good game every once in a while.
But I'm sure you care about the game tomorrow against the Samsung. What is your game plan? What is your preparation?
Yeah, we got to get some good recovery tonight because we play again in 24 hours against a good team. But we're looking to go 3-0 in group play and secure the one seed. So we just got to get some rest, do a little research on that team, and get ready to play.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That was just Tony Gaffney after phenomenal.